It's always your childhood memories which stand out when you look back on your life. Or maybe it's just me. When I was growing up, I faced the torment and wrath of my bickering and arguing parents every day. Everything feels bigger when you're that young, probably because your world is so small. You don't realize it at the time, but those moments define your character, personality, and the decisions you make. Dad was in trouble over something at work. He's an animal tester. The company has a great reputation. Unfortunately, Dad stepped over the line a while back, and he's paying for it now. He might lose his job. I have to do something. Fuck the lions, I'm alive, I'm meant to stay away. But I'd be lying if I said I wasn't scared of change. Got the job, not just anywhere, but where my dad worked. They didn't notice because we had different surnames. It was my job to clean all of the equipment at the end of the day. I had a way in. I could sabotage the investigation. I just had to look normal in front of my supervisor.
Well, I only need to know one thing, baby. Where they are.
Officer Gibbons, I'm done for the day, so here's the keys. Yeah.
Say what?
To the death.
In the case of Acor Apache Cosmetics versus Miles Worthington, we're investigating the possibility of unsolicited research into animal cloning on Mr. Worthington's part. ANA Cosmetics take animal rights seriously and have a pristine reputation when it comes to the legal carrying out of its research. Animal cloning is not supported under ANA's policy of acceptable practice towards animals, and Mr. Worthington's overstepping of this boundary is grounds for termination of his contract. Signed, S. Fowler, General Manager. Going along with the testing anyway.
22. 22 years old. He'd hardly been born yet.
When I started my work, I would never have imagined it would cause such misery. As scientists in our research are always being used one way or another, funded by the dogma of the world's corporate structure, I'm completely responsible for this.
No, Miles. I am too. We abandoned our own son because we were too deep in each other's emotions to function as parents.
We killed him by proxy. I make it sound like some kind of goddamn failed experiment.
We can't ignore the past. Nor can we forgive it. The only thing we can do is end it. Start again. Make up for lost time.
Atonement. The last line of defense.
It's a start.